Guys, Ashkonia, and welcome back to Tekken 7. Now, as you can see, Geese Howl has finally been added in. He just came out today. I've been playing him in practice mode for about 10 minutes or so, and he's actually a really fun character. And yes, I am playing in his new map for Tower State. I've only been playing in this area though. I haven't gone like out of bounds to the outside garden yet. But otherwise, one thing I have noticed him is that he's very similar to Kuma. I'll show you how. So if we go to the move list, we'll see a lot of his combos have the quarter circle motions, which is similar to Kuma and Eliza. So let me try to stomp a couple of you quickly. Yeah, it's very similar to how Kuma plays. He has his power bar, which looks very similar to the KOA 14 power bar. I know he was a KOA 14, but otherwise he is a really fun character to play as, but I'm finding it a little difficult because I don't really, I'm not used to doing quarter circle motion, especially on my arcade stick here. But otherwise, I'm actually finding him a really enjoyable character, but it'll take me a while to get used to him. He has some good tools, like, actually let me show you the one. He can actually grab you on the ground. There we go. I think that's really cool. He seems to be like an all-rounder personally. But if you don't play as a Kuma or you can't really do quarter circle motions, you're probably gonna have a hard time in the boss period and stuff kind of thing. But he is a really fun character to use. Grabbing. Gotcha. Alright, so I'm just gonna go into a treasure battle and play a few matches there. I haven't really been playing with Geese Howl, I only went into practice mode with him, but yeah, let's just see how this goes. These two players, I've actually looked at both his outfits. I checked customization mode with him to see like what you can customize him with. He has like his retro outfits and whatnot, but I really like his player 2 outfits, so I'm actually gonna give that a shot and see how it looks. Now, I actually didn't want to say something. When he was first announced, I had no idea who he was because I never played any SNK titles. Only one I did play was King of Fighters 13, which didn't have Geese out at the time. But when I saw gameplay of him in the trailer, I thought he was going to be really cool because he looked really cool. So I was like, alright, cool, let's try this guy. The next character will actually be Noctis Lucius Kyler from Final Fantasy. And I am super excited for him, although he does look a lot like a Soul Calibur character, but I'm very excited about the DLC characters. Geese Howl has been a lot of fun so far. Granted, I've been playing him for 5 minutes, but otherwise, yeah. Hopefully I'll learn him pretty soon and not get destroyed, like you see now. Okay, alright, there we go.
Round 2.
I like his key charge. Oops. There we go.
KO. You win. Stay down,
maggot. That's pretty cool. Alright, double damage.
Fight.
I should have done something here.
KO.
Alright.
Round 2. Fight.
Alright, it doesn't seem to have wave dash or backdash. But if I try backdashing, he does move quite fast.
KO. You will know your place.
That's really cool. Alright, let's actually go into his character episode to see what it's about, and he does not have one. Okay. That's a little odd.
Come on. Show me that power of yours.
Oh yeah, Claudio. Oh damn.
Round 1. Fight.
I have no idea what to play as Geese yet, sorry guys. I need other very basic combos, but hopefully I'll get used to him soon. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a story episode yet, but I don't know, maybe I'm not sure. Sweet, perfect! Yes. Yes!
Round one. Fight.
Oh, missed! Okay, wait, come on. Yes! Can we try the reversal? Come on. Hit me! Really? His rage rod is also really cool. I like his rage rod. He has two, but the second one's really difficult to pull. And I'm dead. Ah. There we go. Oh my god, that is a lot of damage. Okay. So it's a pretty difficult reversal to execute, but it actually does a lot of damage. Okay. It's pretty difficult to time, but his AI is really hesitant to do it. Oh, sweet. I'll get promotion. I do want to actually claim that I am using mods. I'll put them in the description. Most of the mods are from Godlike Kings 99. I think that's his name. I'll put a link to his mods below. He has some really, really cool mods, actually. Okay, I'm not doing it right. Okay. Stop! I can never fight Devil Kazumi. What did I do? I did key charge, didn't I? No. Okay. Please don't block this. Sweet! Oh, that is so cool, the background. Yes! Howard Estate, brilliant. And I can't lose. Not in this area. Never mind. Oh, I need to be careful now. Fight. Yeah, this is the remix of the Fatal Fury version. Because in round 1 they used the Fatal Fury version of Geese, how it's named, so it's not a non-new mix. But in the second round, I think they use a remix version of the Fatal Fury one. Let's see. Sounds pretty cool. Can't execute this, can I? I know a lot of people actually prefer some of the older ones, like the Fairwave. I think the Fairwave 96 theme song a lot of people like, but I personally love the Fairwave 14 Geese Howard theme song. That one's really cool. At least in my opinion.
Fight.
recognize his laws.
Round one. Fight.
Oops.
KO. Round two. Fight.
I'm doing the wrong things.
You know
Oh, what? Alright guys, I'm probably just gonna end it there. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really enjoying Guy Salward. Granted that I suck with him a lot, but I think he's a really fun character to play as. The new stage is also really cool. His BGM is actually really nice, even though I know a lot of people prefer the other versions. But otherwise, yeah, I think Guy Salward is an absolute must own, especially if you like SNK games or whatever. I think he's a brilliant character. I know like if you can train with him, you probably do really well with him. But otherwise, yeah, I really like Guy Salward. I think he's such a brilliant character, so I definitely recommend him to anyone. Anyway guys, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a big thumbs up. And if you enjoy gaming videos, don't forget to